Hey Xylem, I'm here to show you how we're going to box up the new AP Pros. So first thing, grab our box here, put it right up here. Hopefully soon we'll have some die cut boxes laid out here. Use this hook here, that'll hold the top open. And the next thing we want to do is get our foam sides and ends. So we have those over here. Large ends, and large sides. And in case you need to know, we've got everything, the dimensions on top here. These are just an inch and a half high density foam. So. And when we're gluing these things down, just want to note that there's a membrane on here. Mm-hmm. We always want to glue the membrane facing towards the inside. So membrane, not on top or bottom, facing inside.
Yeah. Glue the non-membrane side. That will ensure that you get the perfect dimension, inch and a half, so that you can fit the foam body or the AP Pro bodies inside the box.
Also, glue usually and out of here, so here it's easy to pull this off on the membrane side. Anyways, so I'm gonna start gluing our ends on here. Doesn't have to be too much. And when you're putting it on here, you wanna make sure it's nice and flush on this end here, on the sides.
Very important to make sure it's flush. If it's not flush, the bodies won't fit inside of the box correctly.
Yeah, same thing with the other side. Alright. Now we're going to do our front. Same idea. Membrane facing the inside. Make sure it's nice and flush on the edge of this box here. It lines up nice with these ends.
Very nice and flush.
Alright, and on the back side, it's going to be a little bit different. Add a little bead of glue here.
So, Ben is placing this foam strip a little bit further back than it needs to be. And then we're going to close the box on top of it. That's going to push it into the perfect spot. Yeah, you want to make sure you close the box on top of it, because if you glue it too far back and it stays there, the box isn't going to want to close correctly. And it's also important that you don't put the foam too far that way, because then the space on the inside isn't going to allow enough room for the bodies, which are going to go in pretty soon. So
right. try to follow that protocol here. So we've got our bodies here. These have already been prepped and cleaned. You can see they fit really nice and snug here, no gaps or anything. That's what we're going for.
That is why it is so important to make everything nice and flush, because it's a tight fit.
Now, if you do have any struggles with that, it's pretty easy to pull this foam off. I just kind of pull it off like this, and I'll come right off. And then I'll set my body in and just wiggle it and put it on there. Not too much, so it doesn't get any glue on the body. And then the next thing we want to do is add our spacers in here, our cardboard spacers.
Mm-hmm.
Now, down here, we've got all of the spacers you need, nice and labeled with their sizes. And you also notice large, 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 small, and small, so you know which boxes they go with. So I'm going to grab the 9 3/4. Fit it nicely in there. my next body. And I want to make sure that this pinched end is on the other side. So you see the pinched end over here. I'm going to flip this one around so it's on this side. And push it up to there.
Yep. You want to stagger the boxes so it's nice and even when it's all boxed up.
Step is to add the tops in.
Yep. So there's only three bodies per box. Don't try to fit any more in there. Three bodies per box.
I've got my tops here. They're already countersink, and they have the inserts in them now.
They have been prepped.
They have been prepped.
So you want to place those tops on that edge of the box because it's heavy. And that's the strongest edge of the box once it's all sealed up, so just make sure to place it on that back edge.
Alright, we're going to add our bags in here. So that's one bag per body. So that's three of these blue bags and three of these clear bags. Sit them in there. And then we want to add our inserts here. We go right over it. We've got our large inserts and the small inserts and the sizes for them. And these fit pretty tightly, so. Alright. And right here in this gap right here, we're gonna add our hooks right here, and you can grab them up here. We've got some already pre-bent. If you need to bend them, we've got this little jig here.
Mm-hmm.
So just gonna line them up neat. Got our bags here. So in our bags here, we've got 12 clips. So that's 4 clips per body. And then we've got 3 of these hooks. You can see here. Oop.
Where are they at?
There, I'll show you right there. Hooks.
They're in there.
And then you're gonna have one Jolly Rancher.
Very important to have the hooks in there.
Yep. You're gonna set that in here. You wanna make sure it's nice and flat. Sometimes I'll just kind of open it a little bit to let some of the air out. It's easier to flatten it out. And then close it back. And just one strip right across here. And then the last step, most important, is make sure you've got some instructions in here. Now, this is your first time making a box, and I always like to check. You've got an AP Pro checklist that tells you everything you need to have in the box.
Mm-hmm.
Alright, so you can always double check before you package everything up. Close this up. Overlap on the sides here, just like that. Get it as nice as you can. Hopefully when we get our new boxes, so fit nicely all the way to the end.
Make sure to push this down really nicely. You don't want any extra room inside of the box.
On the edge. All the way around. It's nice and closed up. It's not opening anytime soon. tape up here. One more thing. We've got these stickers here. Put this handcrafted and torque columns right here in the corner. Nice and neat. One sticker right here on top. And then we've got our stamps laid out over here. So make sure to lay flat when opening. Get that stamped on here.
Last thing, order number.
Take our orders. Right here. Make sure you write the invoice number on the side.
See it? Anyway, it's
yeah, it's kind of hard.
Invoice number is on there. That's what you want. So, we're going to put the invoice number right on the end here. It is 70692. And it looks like there's five of these, so it's going to be one of five.
And I like to put another strip of tape on top of that.
Yep.
So that I can smear off.
Sweet.
And that's it.
That's done. Ready to go over to shipping. That is the AP Pro Box.